How did it handle the guys who come out? Let's play Danganronpa.
We grab the Havoc.
With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We found out Monokuma's control room. We searched from the lockers and got like a card which lets us go anywhere. And the body's gone missing as well. I get the feeling that RG2 is behind Monokuma flower. Is it true it's really paper plastic people? I think it's really related to the case, but it does act as a sort of kind of good bin. That's just what I'm thinking anyway. Leave area, yes. So let's go to the bio lab, which is I think right around the corner. I think that's the last place we've got to inspect. Maybe there'll be something else in the dojo. But for now, let's just go in here. And see what's going on in here. Ooh. Freaking Mr. Freeze sat in the corner.
What killed the dinosaurs? The Ice Age!
Mr. Freeze! Back to Batman. It's like abnormally cold. I feel like I'm in a giant refrigerator. Seriously, why is it so cold? It's a bio lab, you fool. Okay, taps, though, the taps. There's a stack of taps here. You're seeing a lot of those things lately. I know. Ugh, so cold. Why is it so cold in here? It's the first thing I need to figure out. Jesus, stop trying to shoehorn me into doing things in a certain order. There's some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. And on the left side, there's a bunch of glowing blue lights. But on the other side... Oh, there's no blue lights. Some kind of weird machine or something built into the wall. Some kind of thing handled and stuff. It's a fridge for storing dead bodies. Does that mean this biolab is actually a morgue? Should probably take a closer look around. Okay. So now does that mean I can look at everything else? Oh, there's some kind of booklet here. It looks like an instruction manual. We offer an eco-friendly alternative to standard dry ice for all your cadaver needs. In addition to the germicidal lamps, they also provide an ozone generator for removal of ethylene gas. Simply insert the cadaver and the blue light will let you know the automated system has activated. Temperature and humidity levels will be adjusted automatically for optimum settings. With our system, anyone can keep a body fresh as a daisy for as long as you need. In the unlikely event of a problem, the red light will activate and the alarm will sound immediately. The exterior is a stainless steel and we do offer an optional leather upholstery upgrade package. This is the instructional manual for the fridge. Huh. I guess. Let's have a look at that then. There's a stack of tabs here. I guess we need to look at the other side then. Some kind of weird machine. Oh, some of the lights on. The ones on the left. The right handed lights are off. Looking around, I think I get it. Seems clear to me now. It was a makeshift morgue. Biolab Seeker has been out of a true police section of your handbook. And about those lights. Looks like a setup so that when a slot is occupied, the blue light comes on. Which mean inside each slot lit up in blue, another one of the victims is. How would he fool me fit into one of those? Okay. Can't let my emotions take control right now. There's the only thing I can do for everyone who's died. And that's defeat the mastermind. And to do that, I have to continue my investigation. I don't have any other option. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many people died? Let's just want to check this. I'm always like pedantic about things like this. So let's count how many people died. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so that's good. All 9 bodies are in order. Just wanted to check that just in case that's a stickler. Because like, that's the sort of thing you need to think about when you... hold on, that sort of thing. So where am I going? Let's have a look at... I think I've got a truth bullet saying places to investigate. Not. So, headmaster's room we've been to, biolab we've been to, Monokuma Door Data Center. Dojo. Okay. I had a feeling I'd have to go to the dojo, so let's have a mosey on over. See ya. Right. I'm gonna have to look in the locker room. Hello, Toko. Oh, Toko, this is where you were.
What do you want?
Alright.
I'm so disgusted. You want me out of your set?
No, that's not it at all. I just thought maybe you found a clue.
Well, I hear you haven't. I didn't find anything, not one single clue. I figured since this place were related to the case, it would have to have something, right? There wasn't anything out of the ordinary. Give it back! Give me back my precious time!
Calm down, Toko.
What's your problem?
Don't tell me to calm down. You have any idea what I am going through right now? And if I fight, I'm going to come useless. Good for nothing.
Nobody's going to say that.
Master Who?
I'm not sure I can disagree with that. He will.
I don't want that. I'm sick of always being locked down. Why won't anyone accept me?
Well, I don't think there are any clues here, so maybe I'm going to get going. No, let me have a quick look. There's a bunch of wooden lockers here. I found a clue in here, but it was just a mastermind's attempt to frame Kyoko. Okay. I guess. Oh! Oh, it's not time already! Oh, I was having fun.
This is a school announcement. Is everyone working hard? Is your investigation coming along nicely?
Yes.
Well then, since you're all giving it your best, your generous headmaster will give you a little hint.
What sort of hint?
For those of you who are interested, please make your way to the gym ASAP possible.
As soon as possible. Why didn't you just say ASAP, you freaky bear? What? Now he wants to give us a hint? It's suspicious, there's no doubt about that. This could be a trap. But even knowing that, he said to go to the gym, right? It could be trying to throw us off, because hello. Oh, hey, hero.
Oh, Makoto.
Why'd you act so surprised?
Oh, no reason.
We had Monokuma's announcement, right? You need to find out what he has to say.
I just did, actually. I'm on my way out.
You already talked to him? What do you say?
Listen, sorry, but I gotta go.
Hero, wait. There's no point in trying to stop him. You're off like a frightened animal. Hero? It's like he was trying to avoid me. I was going to talk to him about the notebook I found in the locker. He's been hiding something this whole time. Probably. But a shady hero. Oh, is it just going to be me? Oh, that's badass.
The ultimate showdown. Monokuma versus Naegi.
I am Monokuma!
Hello, welcome, hello. Are you ready for your final hint? What just happens to be the envelope on the ground in front of you?
Envelope? This thing. So must be the envelope.
And just so I know, I won't be answering any questions about what you'll find inside.
What?
Don't worry, just get on with it.
Okay. Monokuma's cryptic words didn't make me feel any better, but I picked up the envelope and opened it. What I found was a single photograph. Oh, shit. My god, the entire crowd's here, man. Featured a bunch of faces I recognize extremely well. I mean, you've got Celeste, you've got Owada, you've got that guy who I first. I can't remember all the characters' names off by heart. It looks like there's also Mukuro there, just above Sayaka, next to Hiro. And Junko behind. Oh god, she was the first to die, wasn't she?
This game sucks.
We all look happy, like we all know each other. Question mark, though. Where am I? Where's Naegi? There's everyone who comes out to speak at the same time as me. Wait, but there's someone behind Sayaka. She's the only one I don't recognize. Wait, that's not true. I do recognize her. That's right. When Byaku and I were in the headmaster's room when we looked at that file. Mukuro Ikusawa. Then this girl is... What? Why? Why is Mukuro here with everyone else? And even more than that... I'm standing here on your pose like this is weird enough by itself. I'm all wearing matching uniforms. I don't remember anything like this. And now that I'm looking at it, it's not even everyone. I'm not in the picture. I'm the only one not there. The picture is all 15 of the students, but not me. But I guess that makes sense. For all, I don't remember ever taking a picture like this. I went to junior high with Saika, but the first time I met everyone else was when I arrived here at Hope Speak Academy. So it's natural for me to not want to be in this picture, but what's definitely unnatural is that everyone else is in the picture. I thought everyone was like me and didn't know each other till they got here. But if this picture is real, then could that mean... Could it be everyone else and just me? Everyone here except me is...
I think I'm gonna keep up this rambling soliloquy of yours, Hamlet.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna get him voiced anywhere, you know. So, I mean, get out!
But...
I told you, I'm not fielding any questions.
Unbelievable.
What kind of mystery was being gave all the answers? I'm totally out left field. Don't
let that means he's done talking.
Damn it.
Good photos made out of the truth bullet section of your handbook.
Selfie!
What did, like, Hero get then? So in the end, all I found in the gym was even more confusion. With that confusion in hand, I left the gym dejected. Oh, shit. How does that count as a hint? Just made me even more confused. Is that what Monokuma was going for? Did he put together a fake photo just to confuse me? But it looks so real. So full of life. How can I not fake that? Which would mean everyone but me. You should just ask everyone directly. I should clear all this up. No, I have to clear all this up. Okay. Just go speak to everyone one by one then.
Right, you bastards.
Hina's running around telling everyone where... Actually, let's go speak to Kyoko. I think she should be okay by now. I think she should have had a good old cry, so... Okay, I've come to the archive and I've found Tagami. Oh, Byakuya. Listen, do you think we could talk? Byakuya?
That's enough.
I have nothing to talk to you about. Don't talk to me as if we're friends. Hey, Byakuya, wait. Of course he didn't. He just walked away. What the? Why was he acting like that? Like he was purposely trying to avoid me. He's trying to distance me from everyone else, isn't he? Monokuma. You know, division in the ranks or something. Divide and conquer sort of thing. It's a good strategy, but... big risk if it doesn't pay off. Okay, I've come to the garden to see Hero. I think he should be in here somewhere. Yes. Hero, he stopped being a jerk. Hey, Hero.
Makoto.
What's going on with you? Every time I see you, you freak out like that.
No. Sorry, but I'm in a big hurry.
Once again, he ran off like a terrified rabbit. Hero, what's wrong? Still wasn't able to talk to him about the notebook I found. It's like he was avoiding me. Like he was afraid of me. Why? Oh, what an absolute piss take. Yes. Okay, now we're in the bio lab. I decided to visit the bio lab one more time. The first thing I saw when I got there was her passed out again. Oh shit. Huh? Toko? She opened the locker. It's open. Oh, but Toko. Just step over her unconscious body. Toko, are you okay? No. She's not dead, is she? Doubtful. Hello, Fist Girl. It's been too long.
It's cold. It's super cold. It's so cold. I think I might catch cold.
If you keep taking naps in place like this, I'm sure you will.
What? I was asleep. I must have fainted again. But you're standing there staring at me, getting all excited, weren't you?
No, I wasn't.
Oh, come on. How to move it straight up, honey.
Okay, so why did you pass out?
Oh no, last thing I remember was me waking up just now. What'd you do to Miss Morrow's?
Oh, that's right, your memory stops and starts each time you switch.
Bingo Bazinga, we share some basic knowledge, but our memories are very much separate. Well, don't say that's a bad thing. It's a blessing as far as I'm concerned. Because even if she forgets something, I totally remember. So it's like a double memory.
No, it's more like half. Genocide Jack's memory has been out of a troop with a section of your handbook.
Oh, no, right now. Where's my little darling? Tell me now, I'll sit your throat.
I don't know. I'm sure Byakuya is around somewhere doing his own investigating.
Yes.
By himself?
I assume so.
Oh, I'm on fire.
I know it. I totally know it. I'm a total pro when it comes to all things master. Anyway, I gotta hurry. I imagine how lonely you must be right now.
Oh. Toko shut off, her eerie laughter echoing behind her. Oh, I totally forgot about the picture. Well, there's no point asking Genocide Jack anyway. Besides, there are more important things to do right now. Why did Toko faint? There's obviously some reason for it. A body man. The fridge is open. I'm sure we all shut tight last time I was here.
That must be why she passed out.
Right. Oh, Kirigiri, you babe.
She faints so easily.
Kyoko.
It's getting late, isn't it?
Are you okay?
Indeed.
I'm sorry if I made you worry.
No, you don't have to apologize.
But listen, about this room.
Oh yeah, it's...
It would seem...
It's a morgue.
Yeah.
I knew it.
I suspected as much. We took all the stuff that's inside the fridge, seen what was in there, and, well, there you have it.
You knew she'd fainted?
I was on my way here when Genocide Jack came in and passed me. I assume she must have sneezed, but once I got inside, the real reason became clear. Actually, she came here to investigate, and when she opened the slot there...
That's when she saw the body inside and dropped like a bag of rocks. Why has everything got to be so difficult with her?
Anyway, we should close it up. Don't leave it hanging out open like that.
Yeah, good idea.
Give me a hand with this.
Kyoko approached the fridge, hands outstretched. But suddenly she stopped. What's wrong?
Listen. Maybe we should wait a second before closing it.
Huh? How come?
Because Makoto's body is in here.
Makoto's corpse? Makoto's body is inside the fridge?
Just like every other time. The mastermind probably brought it up here while we were in the class trial.
Mastermind did it? Because they assume we wouldn't be doing the class trial over again, I guess?
So...
You may be right. Either way, now I can finally get a good look at the body.
Oh, that's right. Kyoko didn't get a chance to check the body during the last investigation.
Makoto.
I need to do my own examination of corpse as soon as possible. I want to find a clue this time. I'm going to grab the mastermind by the tail.
Okay, so what should I do?
So then...
Why don't you just wait over there? I'll let you know as soon as I'm finished.
Just wait over there? That's it? Well, I'm not really going to be useful for anything else, am I? Okay. Hello, you find anything? Should I ask Kyoko about the group photo? After all, she's in it too. Don't let me interrupt your investigation. I wanted to talk to you about something.
What is it?
It's about an announcement Monokuma made earlier.
You mean what about a hint or something? I didn't take him up on the offer.
Eh? Why not?
Because...
The only reason he gives a hint at this point would be to confuse us or to cloud our judgment. I can solve this mystery on my own without whatever hints he may have to offer.
That's a good point. She could go back and do the same thing, but what's done is done, I guess. Standing here looking at her. I don't think she's hiding anything from me. Is she right? Did the mastermind forge that picture as a trap to confuse us? That's gotta be it. There's no other explanation. Okay, found a body. Surrangement storing dead bodies. I can't do it. I can't look inside. You know, I think I've seen a tart like this before. Ah, it's the same as the one I found in the garden tool shed. If I remember, that tart. It had a stamp on it that said Biolab. And that's the tart that was used to help camouflage a murder in the garden. At some point, someone got it from a Biolab and took it over there. Okay, tart has been updated. Okay, did you find anything?
It would seem that the light comes on when the slot is occupied.
So when someone's in there, the blue light comes on. Looking around the number of lights that are on, including Mukuro's. There's 9 in all. 9. 9 lights? Biolab lights has been updated in the truth bullet section of your handbook.
Okay, Mukuro, I'm done.
Already? Jeez, that was fast.
You know, I can do good work if you...
Hang on a minute. I said before when I was going through the report card. Okay. How many students are here? So we've got... Oh, I said 9, but this doesn't include Mukuro. Wait, what?
You can do good work if I go slow, and that's better. I'll make my report brief.
So did you find anything?
I pay careful attention to the wounds and the traces of blood, and it seems highly likely that the stomach wound and blood to the back of the head were inflicted after death.
Really?
The burnt tissue made things a little difficult, but I'm completely confident in my findings.
So that means 9 for foes with a fatal injury, right? Then what was the fatal injury? Due to the explosion, victim's identity was unknown. They were, however, dead before the blast. The victim had been stabbed a single time with a knife which went completely through the body. They had also been struck in the head with an object about as thick as a metal pipe. But it was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old. The only other option is those other wounds, but the file said they were old.
Is that right?
What does it say they're old?
Huh?
What the Monokuma file says if they were inflected at least several days ago.
I guess I don't see the difference.
The difference is immense, considering the impression they give.
Listen.
You seem to be equating several days old with simply old.
However,
but that doesn't quite follow logically. Old wounds, it makes it sound like they've been there forever. Like they're not related to the murder.
Are you saying they are? We got the Monokuma file right after she was killed, right? So if the wounds are at least a few days old, there's no way they could have had anything to do with it.
So then.
But what if Makoto herself wasn't killed within the last few days?
Oh! What?
Suddenly you can allow it as one of the many possibilities, can't you?
Oh! So are we talking along the realms of a... already created body? Question mark. One of many.
Right. Detective doesn't have supernatural powers. There's no particular answer from the beginning. Instead, the ideal detective begins by imagining as many possible scenarios as they can.
In other words,
they envision these possibilities without prejudice, without bias, using only their logic and common sense. Then, as we investigate, they test what they find against each of these possibilities. Of course, me telling you this doesn't mean you'll be able to do any good at detective work. But beyond using that to solve this particular mystery, you should keep it in mind for the future.
Hey.
So, if there's anything else you'd like to know about the conditioning body, now's the time.
Yes. Come to think of it, there was one thing. Earlier, when I was looking at Makoto's profile, it listed her height and weight.
So...
5 foot 7 inches, 97 pounds. Vitals were 31, 22, 32. Did I get all that right?
You remembered all that?
They are indeed consistent with a corpse.
So then...
Indeed.
And don't forget about the Fenrir tattoo. There's absolutely no mistake.
Indeed.
Our victim in this case is, without a doubt, Makoto Ikusawa.
Okay, Makoto Ikusawa's probably been updated in the Chocolate section in your handbook.
And?
Is that all you wanted to ask?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, sorry, I have no further business with Makoto's body. Let's get going. It's kind of chilly in here.
Oh, wait. Are you not going to put the body back? Don't you think it's kind of sad leaving it out like this?
Why?
Sad? Did you forget? She was our enemy once. A part of ultimate despair.
But she still got killed. She's still a victim.
Hey. Never heard the phrase, you reap what you sow.
Well, yeah, but still.
You really are naive, you know that. It's really quite appalling.
Shut up, bitch!
But she could have abandoned me. She decided to help me instead. So for someone like that, what does it mean to be naive?
So then,
I think we've done all we can do here. Back to our separate investigations, yes?
Ah, hold on. Still have one more thing to do. Something I need to talk to Kyoko about. I need to ask her about a pocketbook I found in that locker. I don't do it now. Okay. Let's ask her. Hey Kyoko, I have one last thing. I know I shouldn't, but I feel like I have to ask.
Go ahead then, after it.
Have you really not seen your dad even once since you got here?
What?
So...
What do you mean?
Well, you know those lockers on the second floor of the dorms?
I do, yes. But to get into any of those lockers, you need the handbook of whoever the locker belongs to.
Actually, I managed to get them open using my emergency handbook.
See.
The one you found in the headmaster's hidden room.
And?
So, did you find anything worthwhile in the lockers?
I found a pocketbook, and after looking through it, I think it must be your pocketbook.
Why is that?
What makes you say that?
Because...
Like I said, one of the locker's owners should be able to get into it, right? I can't imagine those lockers belong to any of us. After all, we only got access to that area just recently. What I'm saying is, there's no way I could have had access to any of those lockers. And if I did have a pocketbook, why'd I bother putting it in a locker?
Everything you just said makes perfect sense, but there was something written inside. It was about the headmaster, about your father.
If that's true...
Could that mean? That video is real too.
Video?
Makoto.
I think everything's fine starting to fit together to reveal a cohesive picture. Although, I'm afraid that picture might be worse than anything we could have imagined.
What are you talking about?
I need to go investigate those lockers right now. I need to confirm what you just said with my own two eyes.
Oh, let me give you headmaster's handbook, that way you can...
So...
That won't be necessary. If I'm right about this, I don't have any problem opening the locker with my own handbook. After all, it would seem that it's my locker.
Your locker?
If you watch this, it'll all make sense.
DVD? It says class number 7-8, urgent
so...
interviews.
I found in that hidden room after you left. I don't have time to explain exactly what I think it means, so just watch it and see for yourself. I think you realize exactly what it means. Understand why you find my pocketbook in a place none of us have ever seen before.
None of this makes sense right now. I guess that means there's some important clue on this DVD. Okay.
Makoto.
Oh, and now it's my turn. Do you have a second to listen to me ramble?
We do, Kirigiri, but not in today's episode. You'll have to wait till next time, so... Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all...
in the next video.